This screencast is going to go over a sensitivity analysis, and we're going to generate a tornado plot. A sensitivity analysis is basically a study into how sensitive is the process, so the process outputs, to the inputs. So just as an example here, we have a process, and it's got a bunch of inputs, and it may have one or more outputs. An example might be a reactor where the inputs would be things like the temperature, the pressure, maybe the size, flow rate, concentration of different things, and so on. And the outputs might be conversion, just a simple example. And we want to determine how sensitive the outputs of the process are to the inputs. The specific example I'm going to be working with has to do with net present value. We've made a screencast on this already, and you don't necessarily have to understand this net present value example. It has to do with engineering economics and determining the net present value of a venture 15 years from the current time. And we have different inputs to the process. The inputs would be things like the cost of land, cost of royalties per year, the total depreciable capital. That's how much you have to invest in major equipment. Working capital, startup costs. We have sales, which is S. Other inputs include tax, because tax rates might change. And cost of sales, here we have $6 million, and we have an interest rate, or the cost of capital. So again, you don't necessarily have to understand exactly what I've done in this spreadsheet to understand sensitivity analysis. The important thing is that we have a process, and we have multiple inputs that go into determining what the output is. And for this process, the output is down here. This tells us that the net present value of a venture, based upon our base case or our baseline or nominal values of these different variables up here, the net present value of that is about $58 million. We're going to now do a sensitivity analysis. We're going to see what happens when we change different values here for the cost of land, maybe the annual sales and annual costs, and so on. So what happens maybe if we subtract 20% from the nominal values and increase 20%? So you'll notice here, I have 58.78 million down here, and if I change something like cost of sales, let's just say to 8, instead of being 58.78, it's a lot less, it's 50.30. So you can see that this process, the output, which is net present value, depends upon the input variable. So I'm going to put that back to 6, and you know, maybe I change land to, instead of 5 million, it's negative 4 million. But that didn't change it a whole lot. It was 58.78, now it's 59.78. So I'm going to put that back to minus 5. We're going to do a data table to look at these different input variables and what effect they have on the output. So we're going to do a sensitivity analysis first on the working capital. The nominal value, or the baseline value for working capital, is negative 20 million. That's how much we're going to request for working capital. And we want to ask ourselves, how sensitive is the net present value after 15 years? How sensitive is that to the working capital? So if we have 80%, that would be minus 16 instead of minus 20, as opposed to 120%, which is negative 24. So all I've done here is multiply our baseline value of negative 20, which is up here in our spreadsheet. I've multiplied that by 80% all the way up to 120%. We're going to make a data table here. When you make a data table, we have a column of different inputs that we're going to do kind of a case study on. The cell one up and one over from our values, this is a pointer formula, so I'm going to do equals, and that's, we're pointing to our net present value, that's the result. And then what I can do is highlight all of this, our column of cells, plus one row above, and I'm going to go into data, what if analysis, data table. And this is a column data table, and each of these working capital values is going to be placed into cell B4 up here. And so I'm going to press OK, and it's going to do sort of a case study on that. I forgot to mention one thing. If I just did a multiplication of cell C33 here, which is negative 20, times the percentage, and created a vector here, I actually have to copy and paste so that's not a formula, because if this is a formula and we put that into the data table, it doesn't quite work right. So we have to copy and paste the values so they're just numbers instead of formulas in this column before we do the data table. So this is telling us if the working capital is negative 16, the net present value is about 62.5 million. And if we increase by 20%, we see that the net present value is about 55 million. So I can go through all of these different values, and the green here represents the baseline values. So we have working capital, which I showed you. I did this for startup costs, sales, the interest rate or cost of capital, land costs, total depreciable capital, and cost of sales. And what I've done for all of these, I've taken the minus 20, which is our 80% of nominal cost, and our 120% of that particular variable, and I made a summary table here. And what we're going to do now is create something known as a tornado plot. To create the tornado plot, I'm going to highlight one of these rows. I go up here to insert chart, and we're making a cluster chart, a clustered bar chart. And right now it's not looking anything like a tornado plot, but bear with me here. I'm going to format this a little. I'm going to go over here and add in axis titles. I'm going to add in a legend. I'm going to go back up here and I'm going to copy. So I'm selecting this Control C. That's the 120%. And I'm going to click in the area, do Control Paste. Now, again, this isn't looking really like a tornado plot, but we have some work to do. We need to change this. I'm going to do Format Axis. And it's going to cross axis values, vertical axis crosses axis value at 58.78. That was our nominal value. So if I go back up here, 58.78 is what is the net present value when we have 100% of all those values. That was our base case. So now this is sort of looking like a tornado diagram. And I'm going to click on one of these series, format data series. We're going to do 100% overlap, okay, sort of eclipsing. And I'm going to make this a little bigger. I'm going to decrease the gap width, maybe something around 60%. We can further modify this. So I'm going to right click on this axis, format axis. Let's change the number to be zero decimals. I'm also going to click on the category over here and we will format that. So I right click on this, format that axis. I'm going to change the labels so they are low. What that does is it brings those labels to the left side. Another thing I'm going to do is change those labels. So I'm going to do select data. Instead of these 1, 2 through 8, I'm going to edit that. And that's going to be named our categories up here. So I can do that. Click OK. And it has added those different categories. And the last thing we need to do is to change our legend. So I'm going to bring the legend inside here so I can expand this a tiny bit. And I can right-click in here and do Select Data. And I'm going to change this to minus 20%. I'm editing these series. And this will be plus 20%. And we're pretty much done. So that is a tornado diagram. And what this tornado plot shows us is that if we change, for example, sales, if that goes down by 20% of our baseline, then that has a huge effect on the net present value. Same thing with if we increase sales by 20%, that has a very big effect on net present value. Some other things that don't have as big of effect, you see that sea land doesn't have a big effect. If your land costs vary tremendously, that's not going to have a huge effect on net present value at all. But if your sales are off of what you're anticipating, then this can have a huge effect on the net present value. So that's varying from around 20 million to 100 million, which is a huge difference there. And your boss might say, you know, if you gave him this sensitivity plot, your boss might say, well, we need to put a lot more effort into making sure we have a really good estimate on sales, because if sales are 20% lower than what we're expecting, then the profitability of this venture is way lower than if our sales are 20% higher than what we're expecting. This sort of tells you what are the main players in your output, and the output in this case is net present value. And if you really wanted to, you can organize this. You can put the big bars up at the top and the small ones at the bottom, and it sort of looks like a tornado. So that's what the tornado plot gets its name. Okay, thanks for watching this screencast.